She is 22-year-old Zobeyda Esquerra. Good evening. Thanks for joining us. I'm Chris Thomas.
And I'm Madison Wade. Zobeyda's family says that she was shot by a former coworker who had been stalking her for months. ABC 10's Luke Clary has the very latest on this developing story.
It happened around 9 o'clock last night. Gunshots ringing out through this O'Reilly's parking lot. A passing Turlock police officer actually heard the gunshots, the suspect leading police on a chase through town. In the murder of 22-year-old Zoe Esquerra, the suspect leading police on a two-mile chase through Turlock.
He hit this rock.
It came to an end with a crash.
He jumped here, missed the corner of my garage.
In Bob Crawford's front yard.
Went through here, missed that tree.
A neighborhood on lockdown as the suspect jumped backyard fences.
When I opened the door, there's cops everywhere, and they basically said, get inside, lock your doors, and you stay locked down until you hear from us.
The search came to an end when a neighbor saw him hiding in the bushes and dialed 911.
And they took a dangerous person off the street.
Lieutenant Neil Cervenka says the suspect, Juan Francisco Ibarra Tapia, is being held without bail on the charges of first-degree murder. Esquerra died of her wounds at a local hospital.
These are the cases we wish we could have done something to prevent. And all we can do now is our absolute best to make sure that family sees justice.
Esquerra's family say that she worked with the suspect at an O'Reilly's in Livingston, that he began stalking her last summer and was arrested on stalking charges in October. When the emergency protective order expired, they say, he began stalking her again, giving Esquerra panic attacks.
My daughter's the same age as Zoe, so sometimes it hits a little closer to home.
Turlock police say they don't know the status of the stalking charges against Ibarra Tapia out of Merced County right now. He also faces two counts of attempted murder for shooting at employees inside the auto parts store. The good news is they're okay.
Like my buddy said, it almost looked like he floated around that car and floated over to her and did it again. Like he was just not, he wasn't a person.
Only on Fox 40 News, a would-be hero describes how he tried to save the life of a young woman gunned down by an alleged stalker in the parking lot of a Turlock auto parts store. That Good Samaritan who works at a nearby business heard the shots and then rushed to rescue. Thanks for joining us for Fox 40 News at 10. I'm Nikki Lorenzo.
And I'm Eric Harriman. Despite those efforts, she ended up dying a short time later. 22-year-old Zobeyda Esquerra had been stalked by the man now accused of killing her two nights ago. Fox 40's Zach Boeto is live at the O'Reilly Auto Parts store in Turlock. And Zach, from what we understand, this was an act of violence that spread well beyond that business where it happened.
Eric, this is the exact location Zobeyda Esquerra was shot as she waited for her boyfriend to get off work at this O'Reilly's auto store. She was allegedly shot and killed by a man who was obsessed with her, who she used to work with at a different O'Reilly's. The minute those shots were fired, a man working about 20 yards away was the first to come to Zoe's side as she was fighting for her life. 22-year-old Zobeyda Esquerra had just parked at this O'Reilly's to pick up her boyfriend from work when investigators say Juan Ibarra Tapia pulled into the lot, got out, and shot her.
When I heard the woman scream from the first shot, I knew it instantly, so I just reacted.
DJ Terrell Jr. was working at this gas station when he says he heard and saw Ibarra Tapia fire those fatal shots.
Saw the gentleman get out of the car, approach her in an angle and fire on her. And then walked around the vehicle to the backside because he'd parked so close to her, he had to walk around his vehicle. And then proceeded to shoot her a couple more times and then fired at me and then fired back at O'Reilly and then fled the scene.
Employees here at the O'Reilly on Gear have had to board up a couple of the windows because of stray bullets that came from Ibarra Tapia's gun on Tuesday night. After hearing about 10 shots, Terrell says his first reaction was to help.
She started coming to, just making noise and breathing, but only breathing outwards. She couldn't breathe in. So I was trying to do whatever I could, but it wasn't working.
Police say after the shooting, Ibarra Tapia took off down the street in his car, then crashed into this house and ran away.
Honestly, I thought it was a drunk driver, probably hit something out here. But when I saw the cops out here with all the guns out, I knew it was a little more serious than that. The car ended up halfway through that fence over there, and he got out of the driver's side and bolted through my side of the yard and then over my backyard.
Police telling Fox 40 News tonight, this kind of crime is very unusual for this area.
This is a tough case. It's completely surprising and shocking to our community. It's shocking to our officers, and it's disheartening.
Those affected by the violence now calling for a possible change to make stalker laws tougher.
I think they need to change the laws on that stuff. You know, if somebody gets reported for doing that, they need to look at them a little more closely.
I think there needs to be another way to structurally, like, save people from this kind of thing happening. Like, you know, I heard somebody saying also that, you know, if this could have been prevented, this wouldn't have happened. That's very true.
A woman he'd been stalking, and in the months before the murder, we've learned the victim expressed concerns to police. Thanks so much for joining us at 10 o'clock. I'm Elizabeth Kling.
And I'm Curtis Manning. We're streaming right now on CBS News Sacramento. CBS 13's Marley Ginter live for us in Turlock tonight with what a witness said the suspect did right before that killing. Marley?
Yeah, Curtis and Elizabeth, you could imagine how frightening that was. And let me tell you, police tell me tonight that they have confiscated two electronics devices from the suspect's home, along with two of his vehicles and the victim's vehicle that she had driven out here, because this is where it all happened. And just across this side street at a convenience store across the way, a witness watched the entire thing happen.
There was no words, no nothing. She yelled out when he hit her with the first shot.
Donald Terrell watched a horrific scene unfold right next door when investigators say 22-year-old Juan Francisco Ibarra Tapia gunned down 22-year-old Zobeyda Esquerra. Terrell says he'd already seen the suspect circling the neighborhood before trapping Esquerra.
I didn't see his car for a while, but he came back down this road wayside and pulled in right behind her and just jammed her up inside the parking spot where she couldn't get out.
Investigators say Esquerra was parked outside the O'Reilly's Auto Parts store on Gear Road when Ibarra Tapia pulled up and opened fire.
I tried to go get my gun out of my truck, and he had already noticed me and circled around the car and shot at her a couple more times, and then aimed at me, shot over here, and then shot back at the store.
Worries me an awful lot. I couldn't sleep the whole night. I don't think half her neighborhood slept good.
Tony Bianchi showed me surveillance video from his neighborhood where police say the suspect tried to hide until they tracked him down. We're learning it's not the first time he was arrested.
It appears she had done everything she could have done. She had reached out to police. She had voiced her concerns.
I talked with Sergeant Mike Parmley with Turlock Police. According to the Modesto Bee, Ibarra Tapia was arrested in October for stalking Esquerra, who told police she, quote, feared she was next.
There's always room for improvement. I think that the Turlock Police Department is handling this investigation very well. They're working hard, but, you know, ultimately we didn't know that this was going to occur.
I mean, I'm a tough dude, but it gets to me, because I wish I could have done more, or if I didn't do the right thing.
The man accused of stalking and killing her.
That man was supposed to be in court today, but did not show up. KCRA3's Kay Reseda is live from the Stanislaus County Courthouse with the latest. Kay?
We spoke to Ibarra's public defender, but he did not want to say why Ibarra did not show up to court.
22-year-old Juan Ibarra is accused of killing 22-year-old Zobeyda Esquerra. Cameras were not allowed inside the courtroom that he was scheduled to appear in Thursday afternoon, but Ibarra did not show up to court. As we've reported, Ibarra is suspected of gunning down Esquerra Tuesday evening at the O'Reilly's parking lot in Turlock. Esquerra's sister told KCRA off camera that Zobeyda was picking up her boyfriend, who worked at the store when she was killed, and that Ibarra shot at Zobeyda's boyfriend as well. Turlock police investigators say Ibarra shot at one other person. Both Zobeyda's boyfriend and the other person were not injured. Zobeyda's sister says Ibarra and Zobeyda met when the two were employees at O'Reilly's, but the friendship fizzled out after Zobeyda rejected his advances and Ibarra began to stalk her. Zobeyda's sister says the harassment and stalking forced Zobeyda to quit O'Reilly's this past December. Today, KCRA3 learned Ibarra was arrested back in October in Livingston, a case also related to Esquerra. He was charged with stalking, vandalism.
As you can see from the clips, this is a very sad story, and it just breaks my heart. It's reminiscent of Mia McConnell's story, where she was a 19-year-old young lady who was working for an apartment complex, and the maintenance man there became obsessed like a barrel to Tapia, and he eventually ended up killing Mia after unwanted advances that was turned down. I mean, in Mia's story, this guy even went as far as to send her $500 on a Cash App, saying because she was beautiful. And I mean, just, and in Mia's story, as I'm thinking, I'm wondering if the apartment complex did anything about that as well. But I don't believe they did anything because the guy was still working there. And this guy, Caballero was his last name, that allegedly killed Mia. He had a background of stalking women from a previous apartment complex. So it makes you wonder if the apartment complex even vetted or did any kind of, I doubt it. They probably needed workers and just brought on this guy and didn't do, or I don't even know if it showed up on a background check. So I guess I can't say they didn't do their job. I mean, because I don't know if this guy even, you know, listed that or who knows. I just don't know, but it just makes me think about this story about Zoe and how this guy did the same thing. For a year, he was stalking Zoe and, you know, making unwanted advances towards her. And she had to eventually relocate to another job within the same company, but another location. And it makes me wonder, I would love to know more about O'Reilly's. Was that their, you know, their answer to Zoe's, you know, issues with Ibera and Tapia? I would want to know more about what were they doing, or did they care at all? You know, it makes you think, what's wrong with these guys that act like that, that stalk women for no reason? And they don't want to take no for an answer. It makes me think about, there's been a lot of TikTok videos and Ring videos about guys just showing up to women apartments and houses and being recorded on these Ring cameras doing some really sick stuff. One particularly bothered me, where this guy, the woman had went out, I guess she had a dog, and she went out to get her dog, and then she went into the house, and within a couple of minutes, this guy appeared from around the corner of the home, and he was on the Ring camera putting on gloves, and he had snap ties, and you could see the imprint of a gun, and you knew that this guy, he was going to do something nefarious. And he was trying to nudge his way into the door, like pushing his body up against the door to try to almost like break the lock or something. And there's been numerous ones like this. And so as a woman, and especially a mother of a young daughter who's in her 20s, it scares the mess out of me. My daughter and I were talking about how she gets these unwanted advances towards her on social media and even in public. And nowadays, it's not like when I grew up. I'm telling on my age, but it's, you know, when I grew up, guys didn't have an issue with being turned down the way that these guys today are. If you turned them down, most of them would lose interest and move on. Or, you know, if they were petty, maybe put a rumor out about you. I mean, that's not funny, but, you know, put a rumor out about you, or, you know, call your name or something like that. But it didn't really get to the point of violence, or if someone doesn't want you, deciding that you're going to take their life because they're not interested in you. There's 8 billion people, well, over 8 billion people on this earth. No one has to want you. Move on. There are other people. And I'm not saying when I was growing up that the guys were so ideal. They had their issues. But nowadays, it just seems like the guys are so freaking sensitive. I don't understand what's the issue with not being able to handle rejection. And I don't know, maybe these guys that commit crimes like Caballero and this Ibera Tapia guy, maybe there's some mental issues going on, or, you know, something happened in their childhood with a mother figure or a mother. I don't know. That could be a combination of all of it. But I'm just wondering, there's been such an increase of this type of stalking behavior, and where some of it has even, in this case with Zoe and Mia, turned deadly. And these women, I put myself in their shoes, and I'm thinking, like, what could have been done to stop this? In Zoe's case, she did everything she was supposed to do. She contacted the police. She did file reports. I mean, she did everything she could. The woman even relocated to another location at the job just to get away from this guy. And still, she ends up losing her life. So then you say to yourself, what can women do? And this is what's really bothering me, because in Zoe's and Mia's case, what could they do to stop these idiots? No one knows what's going on in these sickos' mind, but it's really sad that they can't take rejection, that they can't just move on. And these are young guys. I mean, Caballero, I think he was in his late 20s, and this Ibero Tapia guy was 22. You mean to tell me never in your life have you ever been turned down by a woman? Or maybe that's the issue. These guys have issues with women. My heart goes out to young women and single young women of today, because you just don't know. I was telling my daughter, when she goes out or she gets unwanted advances, you know, to be very careful of how she responds, how she reacts, because these guys are sick. It doesn't, and when I say this, I don't mean all guys. I'm talking about these stalker types. You just don't know what's on their mind. You would think, you could just say, I'm not interested, or, you know, you see with these cases of Zoe and Mia, they weren't interested, but that didn't stop them. That didn't stop these stalkers, Caballero and Ibera Tapia. It didn't stop them. They kept pursuing. So, you know, it's like, what could these girls possibly have done? What could they have done? So there definitely has to be done, something has to be done more to help young women in these cases where these sickos are targeting them and basically, possibly, threats to their lives. I know with Mia's case, her mom and her dad was working on Mia's Law, where you can work on situations where women at jobs and they're being targeted by some sicko at the job, more strict on helping these girls and being more punitive to these guys, because obviously jail doesn't bother them, or maybe they feel like they're untouchable. Whatever it is, it has to stop. You know, so many young women are being affected. So I will keep you guys updated on news regarding the upcoming trial, in this case regarding Ibera Tapia. And also just wanted to give my condolences to Zoe's family and her friends. So sad that this young woman had to lose her life over someone who can't handle rejection, or if he had issues going on, for some reason he targeted her. And it's so sad, because she didn't deserve this. She did not at all. And my heart goes out to her family and her friends. And also, I just wanted to say to every woman out there, especially young women or women who live alone, please be careful. Get you some protection. I'm not advocating gun rights, but I'm just saying whatever you need to do to protect yourself, take classes, I mean, you know, whatever, taser, whatever, whatever you need to do to protect yourself, but make sure that you have things put into place to protect yourself as much as you can, and especially use those things like that Ring camera and stuff, so that you can have video recordings of things that like this, because you're going to have to, if you run into a case of a sicko, you're going to have to document it. And so you want to document as much as possible. Also, get you some protection, get a dog. And there's a hotline number, and I'll leave that number in the description as well, to women who are being stalked and what they can do, because different states have different laws in regards to stalking and things like that. So again, women, protect yourself, be very careful. Also, if you're approached by these type of people, which you won't know, but with any guy, you know, that just comes up to you and approach you, make sure that you're careful and that you don't take warning signs for granted. And as always, thank you so much for watching.